Snatch Junk.
Hi, everyone, and welcome again to another episode of SNES Drunk Plays. This time I'm going to be playing Ken Griffey Jr. Presents Major League Baseball. Once again, one of my favorite games of all time. But the reason I'm doing this is because I get a lot of like comments and stuff like that on the original video for that I did, the original review of this game that I did, that say this game is really hard, that they can't hit. Every pitch they give up gets, you know, smacked for a homer. So I'm going to play. I'm going to be my hometown Twins here and show you guys, you know, kind of a fail-safe way to play. And I'm going to, just to demonstrate, I'm going to play the defending champs at this point, the Toronto Blue Jays. And I don't remember if I changed the pitcher's name to Clyde on purpose, but that seems to be his name here. That's my dog's name, Clyde. Here we've got the rockin' theme for the national anthem, which is pretty funny. It's actually cool if you play this game in Toronto, you get the Canadian theme, which is a nice touch. Anyway, the key to pitching. See how the pitch bent there? You pitch, start by holding down, and then bend like you're throwing a Hadouken, like Ryu or Ken in Street Fighter 2. Never throw a straight pitch. The computer's gonna swing at whatever you chuck up there, except apparently this guy. And if you get two strikes on him, move all the way to the opposite end, hold up, and curve away from him. And then he'll yell at you. That is what, I mean, do not ever throw a straight pitch, or you'll just get what you're, you know, they'll frickin' smack the shit out of it. Now, hitting is a little different. Hitting, you want to, what's always worked for me, I'm not sure if there's actually anything to this from a fundamental gameplay stance. So far, no, two easy outs. But if you kind of, when you swing, you kind of move towards the ball. You start, I go all the way to the bottom of the box, as you can see. This pitcher has a pattern. I've played this game so many times, I know this guy. I know this is Juan Guzman, and I know he has a pattern. I'm just waiting for the right pitch to hit here. So you just kind of swing into the ball. I got lucky that wasn't caught by the first baseman there. Swing into the ball. Here I got a lefty, Kent Herbeck, up here. Oh, he's Adam West in this game. Yep. So you push it. It's almost like you're pushing it as you swing. So, and obviously there's timing there. You got to get the timing down. That takes a lot of practice. I got runners on second, third, with Dave Winfield coming up, or Jimi Hendrix, as this game has him labeled for some reason. Oh, that was bad. Don't swing at that. But yeah, move to the bottom of the box and swing into the ball like you're pushing it. Please try. Blew a chance there, but yeah, that's the basics to hitting and pitching successfully in this game. Again, no straight pitches. Never a straight pitch. Sometimes they'll even miss. And then you do the, on the opposite end of the D-pad with up. You hold up and move away from the guy to get him to swing and miss like that. Why can't you just do that every pitch? Because it wears the pitcher out faster. And then you have to change pitchers, and that's a hassle. Ooh, I'm going to get this guy. What an idiot. What was he thinking? Nice. But yeah, that pitch does wear out a pitcher faster, I've come to find. But yeah. So, all right, let's try it again here. Sit down. Oh, you swung at a shitty pitch. It's not my fault. Okay, yeah. Here we've got, yep, just looped it over. Nope, doesn't get past him. So, see if I can scratch some runs across here. George Lazenby, a.k.a. Pedro Munoz. Uh-oh. Don't get doubled off. The other thing I should mention, here's Terry Jorgensen here. Oh, that's out of here, I think. If it... goes through the wall. Okay, the old RBI baseball through the wall home run. How far did that go? 398. Not very well by this game standards. Not very far. And here we have Pat Mears, the old Twins shortstop, who was never a very good hitter. I'm gonna try and bunt with this guy just to be dumb. That was terrible. What was I doing? Come on. That wasn't very good at all. Well, anyway, the what I wanted to, what was I saying? Yeah, the other key to this game is picking a decent team. The Minnesota Twins are very average. They have a good lineup, but very average pitching. The Toronto Blue Jays are a very, very, very good team. They're the defending world champs. They have Ricky Henderson, Roberto Alomar, John Olerud, Joe Carter, and in the, I think they have Jack Morris. I forget who their pitchers are at, in this time frame. Wait, what the hell? Come on! Get. Ugh. But yeah, the key is, if you want to be good at this game, is pick a decent team. Don't pick the Colorado Rockies or the Florida Marlins, because they're expansion teams at this time, so they have terrible teams. There we go. Could be a triple play. No, he's too fast to first. Two big outs, though. Oh, get there, get there, get there, get there. Got there. Nice. Yeah, once in a while with the curved pitches, they will eventually, you know, run one down. Or they will, you know, hit one to the corner, hit a couple home runs here and there. But it, I've found it to be by far the most, you know, I've been playing this game for 20 years. And that's what I've been able to do. Here's Kirby. Kirby with a line shot. Kirby Puckett, by the way, if you're not familiar with early 90s Twins. But anyway, yeah, pick a good team. Curved pitches, and push the ball when you swing. Either push it to the opposite field or pull the ball, move the opposite direction, or, you know, if he's right-handed, pull to left field. If he's left-handed, pull to right field, that sort of thing. One of my favorite things about this game, you know, other than the batters shouting at you, the umpire, there we go. Oh! Where the fuck was my shortstop? I love the names. All have themes. And for example, the Toronto Blue Jays, since they didn't have a player's license, damn it. They didn't have a player's license, so they couldn't use the official names of the players. They could use their likenesses and their stats and their numbers and all that, but they couldn't use their names. So what they did... There we go. So what they did is they just went crazy with the names and named them after whoever. In the Twins' case, it's basically just a big... There we go. That could be trouble. Over their heads. Come on. I'm going to stretch this to three. It's going to be a triple for Dave Winfield. Or Jimi Hendrix, as the game calls it. Jimi Hendrix can freaking crush the ball. Nice. Okay, anyway. Yeah, the Toronto Blue Jays are actually named after a rugby team. I don't know any... Oh, shit. I could have sent him. I thought he was going to catch that. Damn. I did not know, I don't know anything about rugby, but apparently the Blue Jays, if anybody out there knows anything about rugby, the Blue Jays are named after the, what is it, the Wigan Warriors? They play out of Greater Manchester, England in the Super League. I just wrote that down. I don't know anything about rugby. But I thought that was really interesting that they really do get their, such a weird collection of names. You're telling me... I'm going to get a leadoff triple, and he's going to get stranded there. Oh, Jesus, that was terrible. Anyway, yeah, I mean, there's what are some other examples? Like, the San Francisco Giants, I think, are all the developers of this game. Boy, this team cannot hit. And they're the world champs, and they have a really good lineup, and it's that curved pitching, I'm telling you. I swear by it, and it works. So... What are some other examples I can think? I know I'm just rambling here at this point. I know the Expos have guys from like the Smiths and New Order and like, you know, those like 80s bands that came from England. What do you call it? One team is nothing but like old movie stars from the 30s and 40s, like Audrey Hepburn and like Jimmy Stewart and Greta Garbo and all those people. And since the California Angels had, or California at the time, I think they were owned by an actor. I forget his name. So they're all famous actors, famous American actors from, you know, everything from Humphrey Bogart and John Wayne and Fred Astaire. Those are all I wrote some of this stuff down. I'm trying to kind of got the bases loaded here. Kirby comes through. Send everybody. Oh, he's throwing home. Damn. Save. Come on, Adam West, a.k.a. Kent Herbeck. Get back. There we go. So what's the score now? 4-0. after that two-run double by Kirby in the bottom of the fifth against Juan Guzman here. If you get five runs, just missed that one. The computer will pull the pitcher if you get five runs against him, the starter. Oh, how did I miss that one? Terrible. Oh, and another weak. Well, just stranded him. Still got four across, though, so far. So, and Clyde is showing no signs of wearing down yet. You'll see the pitcher. We just barely got him. You'll see the pitcher. Was that Ricky Henderson? It was. Oh, come on, get there. Oh, Kent Herbeck dives for it, but can't quite come up with it. The pitcher will start, like, sagging his shoulders and, like, panting a bit. When he starts to get tired, that's a base hit. Oh, how did I miss that? Oh, that was a big screw-up by me. Don't go to third. Don't go to third. But dodged a bullet there. I'm going to try and get a shutout here. Robbie Alomar. Ugh. Right to the guy, thankfully. Damn. Yeah, I'm expecting to see my pitcher start to pant a bit. And when that happens, you probably already noticed there's a few miles an hour off his fastball. I'm just going to strike this guy out and see if he can hit this. I don't think he can. Another thing about doing that strikeout pitch is that it gets less... It gets much harder to curve the ball like that, to bend it all the way to the side of the screen like that. There we go. Got out of it. It becomes much harder to bend the ball because the pitcher is tired, so he's putting less spin on the ball, presumably. I don't know. But... that pitch is less and less effective. It straightens out as the game goes on, or as the pitcher plays on, rather. Boy, I'm not doing so hot here. Oh, and my worst hitter coming up, Pat Mears. Just bunting it. Oh, that's pathetic. Come on. That was a terrible inning. There is one other thing, one other piece of advice I should probably give. I completely forgot to mention, and that's turn auto fielding on if you're having trouble with this game. Don't even worry about fielding at first. You can do that. I've played this game so many times that I know exactly what to expect. Let's strike this guy out here. Yeah, sit down. Just turn auto fielding on. And if you don't want to do that and you want to do it all natural, then one important thing to remember when fielding fly balls in the outfield or line drives is that if you run towards the spot on the map that's indicated where the ball will land, don't overrun it. Just run up to it, and then the spot on the field will like suck the player in. So just run up to it and then let go of the D-pad and let the game do the rest for you. I see a lot of people, when they play this game, when I play against them, they always overrun the ball and then they get kind of flustered and overrun it back. And all you have to do is run up to the spot and let it take you into that spot. It'll automatically kind of suck you in. Okay, here we got Kirby. That ball, that's gone. That's way out of here. See, it helps being the Twins because they have like three really, really good hitters in their lineup that rarely disappoint. They have Kirby Puckett, Kent Herbeck, and Dave Winfield. And Kirby just hit that one 447 feet. See, he just gave up his fifth run, so he's changing his pitcher to some other rugby player. and he put in the lefty to match the lefty here at the plate. Kent Herbeck, why did I swing at that? That was terrible. Anyway, we're just playing out the string here. I'm running out of stuff to say. That's going to drop for a hit. Nice. But yeah, I don't try and pull... I don't usually try and pull the ball, unless it's with one of the best hitters. Trying to steal with Kent Herbeck here. It's not going to work. I did say in the my original review of this game that hitting is all timing. I guess that's not entirely true. I was probably a bit wrong about that. But, damn it, I struck out with Winfield again. Jeez. It's timing and positioning. It's making sure your hitter is moving. See how he's, like, my pitcher right there is kind of panting? Yeah, see, now he's going to start sucking up. He's going to start getting throwing some meatballs there, but I can get out of this. But yeah, hitting is, you gotta slide into the ball or away from the ball. I find it easier to slide. Yeah, just knock the guy over. It's one of my favorite parts of this game. Just knock him over. Yeah. I hate this pitcher. He's not throwing me fastballs. But yeah, it's timing and it's also positioning of the batter sliding into the ball or away from the ball. So that's my two cents on how to hit and how to pitch in this game successfully. Get this pitcher out of here. I hate this guy. He's throwing me nothing but junk. There we go. Good contact there. That's a double. Oh, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the Metrodome. This is the Toronto at Minnesota, so this game is being played. Whoa, shit. Computer never does that. I hate this pitcher. Damn. The Metrodome is like the least enviable. What am I doing? The least enviable place to watch a baseball game on Earth, or at least it was till they tore it down. It was terrible. There we go. It was terrible because it's like it's just a big concrete, just dingy, moldy, smelly. Just about the only. Ooh, my worst hitter got a hit and drove in a run, and I'm gonna send him to third. Yeah, got there. Nice. Yeah, it was a terrible place to watch a baseball game. For football, it was, you know, it's fine because it's football attracts all the drunk idiots anyway, but. Ooh, that's trouble. That's going to go over everyone's head. Nice. Shane Mack comes through. I'm going to send him. Uh-oh, I'm in trouble. Shit. There. No. Damn. Oh, he's finally taking this asshole out. Good. Offia? Yeah. Anyway, yeah, the Metrodome. Glad they tore that place down. Target Field is 1,000 times better. Oh my god, it's a real baseball park. Imagine that. It's a tremendous place to watch a game. Especially sitting behind the plate where you got the skyline behind you. Or the skyline view, rather, to look at behind the stadium. Right now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take out my pitcher. He's tired. And I'm going to put in Rick Aguilera. Or as this game has him listed as Werner Herzog for some reason. But yeah, he's got a beard. He just looks cool, and I like his delivery. And again, just curved pitches, nothing straight. Especially to the meat of their lineup here. I think they got Joe Carter coming up next. Yeah, I might just try and hit this guy. Oh, I can't reach it. He's too far away. Damn. He swings anyway. What an idiot. All right, one out away from winning this one, 7-0. There we go. All right. There you have it. That's kind of my tutorial here for how I'm successful at Griffey Baseball. I've been playing this game 20 years. That's how it works for me. Here we got Kirby going 3 for 4 with 3 RBI, a home run. Clyde the dog pitched a hell of a game. 5 strikeouts. Got the box score there. Take a look at what the Blue Jays did. Oh, they did fairly well. I mean, almost everybody on their lineup got a hit. Pitcher went 6 2/3, and they always put some goofy headline up here, like for fun. Like, I know one of them is like players caught playing Game Boy in dugout or something like that. And yeah, that about does it. Again, curved pitch. I keep saying it a million times, but again, curved pitches. Keep the batter moving. Move the batter in the bottom of the box and push him or slide him over as he swings. And for fielding, just let the player run to the thing and let the game do the rest of the work. Again, thanks for watching. I hope this was at least a little helpful. And have a great rest of your day.